is that thing still doing here for?
Hey, Randy, sorry. I was a little distracted. This bad boy has a lot of sentimental value to me. But don't worry, bro. Been watching a lot of tape and the ideas, they're flowing, dude.
You've been watching a lot of tape?
Mm-hmm.
I hope you mean, Riddle, I hope that you mean you've been watching a lot of tape on our potential opponents for day one, and you haven't been watching just a lot of tape and you wearing the blazer. Riddle.
All right, I've been watching both, bro. It's just that when you're watching stuff, you get, you know, you want to watch something else. And...
Riddle, your broadcasting career was over before it ever began. Now I've told you, you got a list of priorities, and these titles need to be on the top of that list. Do you understand what I'm saying?
I understand, and I completely agree with you. And I think our next move should be podcasters, bro. Dude, did you see the deal Pat McAfee got? Dude, we could be swimming in cold, hard cash like Scrooge McDuck. Or better yet, we could become shamans and give shrewd life advice to people. Yeah.
No broadcasting, no podcasting, no shamans. And stop hanging out with jackasses at the show.
Bro, you gotta admit, last Friday on SmackDown was pretty sweet hanging out with those jackass guys. And you gotta admit, Randy, you were pretty impressed. And could you imagine if I was in a movie like that with Johnny Knoxville, Chris Pontius, and Riddle, dude?
I think you're onto something there. You are a jackass, so you should have been in the movie. You're right. But this is reality. Mm-hmm. And in real time, you are about to fight Otis, a man that's shaped like a human wrecking ball. He's like a bulldozer. I'll tell you what, you prioritize your focus 100% on Otis tonight. You get that W. And then one day in the future, in the distant future, I will allow you to put that blazer back on.
Yes, dude, I'm so focused on Otis, dude. I'm thinking so hard about him.
Change it up. Yeah.